This dissonant beginning, resembling a catastrophe in musical form, is followed by a recitative in the orchestra.
He doesn't actually call it a recitative, but if we look at what the cellos have to play, it does sound very much like one. In other words, the vocal element is anticipated in the orchestra. With this orchestral introduction, Beethoven actually goes beyond what instrumental music had been called upon to express up to that time. Once again, he incorporates non-musical elements into the score. It's more like the beginning of an opera. The sense of disaster that is written into the music seems more fitting for an opera than a symphony.
Here, Beethoven quotes passages from the preceding movements, including the very beginning of the symphony. This interplay between recitative sections and self-quotations continues with motifs from the second and third movements. Then, the Ode to Joy theme finally appears in full for the first time. Subsequent variations of the theme lead ultimately to a powerful orchestral tutti.
Now we get the recitative proper, indicated as such in the score. The baritone sings, "Not in this vein, my friends." This marks the end of everything we have heard so far. It's an appeal to look in a different direction. Let us make our song more pleasant, more joyful, the baritone says, addressing himself at one level to the chorus, at another to the bond that unites the performers and the audience.
Ausführenden und Zuhörern.
That is Beethoven's grand design. At this point, he wants the concert hall transformed into something like a great cosmic stage. Ideally, he would have wanted all humanity to listen and then join him in striking up this more joyful song.
It's no coincidence that the European Union should have chosen the Ode to Joy theme as its European anthem. The anthem-like character, in fact the national anthem-like character of this finale,
is written into the very fabric of the work. It apostrophizes a unifying force that can only find expression in the form of an anthem.
Sozusagen formulieren soll.
Alongside the theme of joy addressed to humanity, Beethoven composes another theme dedicated to the divine principle, "Be embraced, ye millions." In a double fugue, he brings these two ideas together, ideas he'd already noted down in one of his conversation books in 1820.
The moral imperative within us and the starry firmament above us, Kant.
The Ninth Symphony is an absolutely unprecedented work. That was why it took almost half a century for other composers to follow in its footsteps. The Ninth is in fact the origin of a completely new genre, the Choral Symphony. It's a great step forward, not only in terms of sheer size, but also in qualitative terms. This turn to the use of language and the human voice levels a great big question mark at the effectiveness of purely instrumental music.
Beethoven's Last Symphony is the redemption of music from its original province into the realm of universal art.
It is like a miracle, like the burgeoning of a tree with all its buds blossoming at the same time.
Here, art and truth celebrate their finest triumph.